Hey guys, this is the XRP Cowboy.
Hey, this is Billy.
Is XRP a stablecoin?
Make up your mind. Decide to walk with me around the lake tonight. Around the lake tonight, by my side. Gentlemen, behind the boathouse, I'll show you my dark secret. I'm not gonna lie, I want you for my blushing bride, my lover, be my lover, yo. Don't be afraid, I didn't mean to scare you, so help me, Jesus.
My dreamers, Alexa off. My roadies. I was gonna do In the Still of the Night by Whitesnake. It's just a little high-pitched. You guys, I just want to show you something really quick, and then we'll get into it. A little bit of cowboy vision here. Bum, 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 bum. Let's get down to business. I don't want to mess around now. What is this? You guys, my dreamers, ready for this?
I saw it this morning, and I remembered this. I'm pretty sure I've seen this world thing.
A little commercial, but we need to get away from this shit.
Bank document before, but it says on page 31, the Ripple XRP, cross-border retail and Stellar XRP LLM call it a digital currency. Okay, and then in this document, the most important thing is this clip right here. Look at this. Stable coins refer to a class of digital currencies that are relatively stable in terms of their price. Stable coins offer instantaneous processing and security of payments, as many cryptocurrencies do. They also offer stability with respect to their parity against fiat currencies. Two digital currencies that fall into this category are RippleNet's native currency, Ripple XRP, and Stellar Network's native cryptocurrency, the Stellar Lumen, XLM. Both Ripple and Stellar enable faster and more efficient cross-border payments relative to correspondent banking. However, the point is that they just called XRP and XLM stable coins, and I don't think that's by accident. You have to ask yourself why, okay? And we asked ourselves why, and this is the document, by the way. This is World Bank Group, and if you let me do a little search here so we can, here we go, there's XRP, let's go to the next one, right here, stable coins. So this is the section where it talks about them both, okay? Now, here's where that gets interesting. What is it that the World Bank is seeing that, why would they call XRP and XLM a stable coin? I mean, these things, as you know, as a holder, they fluctuate all the time. They're not stable coins. Unless there's a plan for them to be stable coins. That's the only thing that makes any sense.
Great job. You should watch the Digital Investor, but we're going to give our opinion here now with a little cowboy vision. I remember a year ago or so, it was even before the lawsuit, I believe, Brad Garlinghouse was on TV, and he was talking about how XRP is more stable than the U.S. dollar with cross-border payments. And the reason being is because it could take several days or hours. And ultimately, what he was saying is, you know, it moves so quick, the volatility is diminished. It is less volatile than moving the U.S. dollar across borders. Therefore, it is a stable coin. I mean, this is just Brad. What the fuck does he know? So ultimately, I know DAI is going to go into, it's going to be a stable price and this and that. But, you know, it is very important for the mission that Ripple has is to have, you know, for it to be considered a stable coin because it moves so quickly. And yes, the price can be very volatile, you know, but not in 3 seconds. And ultimately, it just reinforces their position with cross borders, Nostra Vostra, on-demand liquidity, and everything else. You know, we could get into that a little more, but ultimately, you know, XRP is a stable coin. And that was the point he was making, and that was the point I'm making. However, with any digital asset, long term, you got to remember, guys, these digital assets that we own, they're like penny stocks. They can fluctuate in the fucking second, up and down. And why are they linked? How are they, is that related? Well, there's not much liquidity, so they jump all over the fucking place like rabbits, okay? The volatility up and down, the human emotions of buying moves the chart all over the place. This is how early we are in digital assets. There isn't much liquidity. I get it. Some of these projects have a lot, and they still fluctuate a lot. But as the market, as it matures, as it grows, this volatility will be gone. And that's when, you know, all the money's made, okay? So just think about it like that. We need this volatility. It's like the old expression, you can't have 10x gains without 50%, you know, corrections. I mean, that's just the way it is. That's how it is with penny stocks. That's how it is with crypto. We are early. I mean, I read something the other day that 6% of the population was invested in digital assets, and half of them are invested in Bitcoin. So you got 3% in all the other alts. And then think about it like this. You have 50%. You've got half the population invested in Bitcoin. And then from a dollar perspective, macro perspective, I'm just kidding. But seriously. And then 50%, of the remaining half invested in Ethereum. So now you've got $5 billion, $500 billion left over for the rest of the market out of a $2 trillion market cap, and what? And 70% of that's probably Ethereum projects. So when you start doing some subtraction, you see how early we are. And ultimately, once just this 6% of the population sees that they should be moving their money to diversify into other assets, we're going to see, you know, huge move in the altcoin prices. However, this is where we're really going. They're only invested 1% to 3% that it's been recommended. So what happens when just that 6%, you know, invests, you know, maybe half their portfolio or 20%? What happens when 20% of the population's delegating 20% of their portfolio to crypto? You guys, we haven't seen nothing yet. We have not seen anything yet. So my dreamers, hold on for dear life, because we're at the beginning. We're at we're not even at the infant state. We haven't even been born yet. So when the price is up and you think you're a fucking genius, tell you what, those words do not define what you are. Those are small words compared to, there isn't a word that can express how great the greatness that we all possess, my dreamers. You with the sad eyes, don't be discouraged, no one realizes it's hard to have courage in a world full of people. We can lose sight of it in the dark, in the night. You feel so alone. I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors.
True colors are beautiful, like your face.
Giving all my roadies and dreamers a fucking hug tonight. You have greatness. You were born great. And I love my fucking people. We are one, my dreamers and my fucking roadies. We're going to walk across the finish line together.